It's a breezy and warm afternoon ahead of the cold front. I'm meteorologist Cyndee Quinn, the UF Weather Center. As we check out our three big things, we're talking about those winds for today, and they're going to be gusting up out of the southwest around 30 miles per hour. So expecting to stay windy through the afternoon and then into the early evening before things finally start to subside as that front approaches. The cold front, though, brings an end to our 80s degree weather that we've been seeing for the last several days. And as we go into the weekend, definitely on the cooler side, looking at high temperatures near 70, and at night our low temperatures into the low 40s. So definitely a lot cooler than we've been used to in several weeks. Temperatures at 8 p.m. still looking at 72 degrees, but notice our wind still sustained around 13 miles per hour, some gusts up to around 20, 25. But as we go into the evening time hours, as winds will continue to slowly slacken off, and we'll see those temperatures during the overnight hours dropping into the low 60s. Best chance of rain starting around midnight, and we'll see it continuing until about sunrise. But again, it's just going to be a couple of spotty showers, and we'll see maybe a couple of spotty showers into late this afternoon. Otherwise, with our weather store, we have the area of high pressure down to the south of us, but notice our jet stream flow is still fairly zonal here across the state of Florida. But as we go into the next upcoming weekend into early next week, it really starts to change, and we're looking at some of the cool air continue to slide on east and bringing back a little bit more seasonal weather here in the state of Florida. Is actually going to be a little bit cooler than normal. So here it is, that flow on Friday. You're still seeing it somewhat zonal, but a big pattern change then coming up for the weekend. Notice how the colder air is stretching from the Ohio Valley, sort of diving on down into Georgia and Frank and encompassing part of Florida. We're looking at, again, some of those temperatures to really start to cool off a little bit, and that's why highs even on Sunday be struggling to get to 70, looking at some spots then still into the upper 60s. And this really sort of hanging on even into the early part of next week before things finally start to moderate a little bit and we get back to more seasonal, if not just a couple degrees above that kind of weather temperature wise. There's a cold front as it stretches across Florida. We'll see it dropping southward. Now again, as we go late this afternoon, a chance of spotty shower, then a little bit better once that front passes on to the south of us. We'll see a couple scattered clouds early on Friday and then clearing. We get into a cool, dry air mass, and our winds will be coming up out of the north and northeast, and that's really going to keep Florida on the cooler side, not just Saturday, but all the way through Sunday and into Monday. So temperatures, here it is, looking at the afternoon on Friday. Highs in the upper 70s. We'll see the clouds and then becoming mostly sunny for the afternoon. Looking at temperatures then Saturday afternoon, cooler, even some upper 60s along the I-10 corridor, and then back along the beaches, even St. Augustine, seeing around 66 degrees. Your extended forecast, so we're going to be cooling things off and keeping them cool. Looking into Monday, temperature is still around 71, but overnight lows on the cool side. We're talking Sunday and Monday morning near 40.